Hi, as you know, the Delhi University literature syllabus has removed the writing of three people, Mahashita Devi's Draupadi, Bama's writing, and Sukirtha Rani's writing. A few days ago, I read the story Draupadi in English translation, written by Mahashita Devi and translated from Bangla to English by Gayatri Spivak. Today, I want to read the author's preface to the book Karukku, written by Bama. This author's preface was written in 1992 by Bama. There are many congruities between the saw-edged Pamira Karukku and my own life. Not only did I pick up the scattered Pamira Karukku in the days when I was sent out to gather firewood, scratching and tearing my skin as I played with them, but later, they also became the embryo, the symbol that grew into this book. The driving forces that shaped this book are many. Events that occurred during many stages of my life, cutting me like karukku and making me bleed. Unjust social structures that plunged me into ignorance and left me trapped and suffocating. My own desperate urge to break, throw away and destroy these bonds. And when the chains were shattered into fragments, the blood that was spilt then, all these taken together. There are other Dalit hearts like mine, with a passionate desire to create a new society made up of justice, equality and love. They, who have been the oppressed, are now themselves like the double-edged Karukku, challenging their oppressors. Although the author of the Epistle of the Hebrews, New Testament, described the word of God as a two-edged sword, it no longer stirs the hardened hearts of the many who have sought their happiness by enslaving and disempowering others. In order to change this state of affairs, all Dalits who have been deprived of their basic rights must function as God's word, piercing to the very heart. Instead of being more and more beaten down and blunted, they must unite, think about their rights and battle for them. Father Mark understood the nature and sources of this book and urged me to write it. Not only did he encourage me to give thought to each separate topic, he supported me in the writing of it. He worked tirelessly to bring it out in the shape of a book and honored it by writing an introduction. I am indebted to him in many ways. Out of many other friends who encouraged and inspired me, I must mention Father M. Jayaraj in particular. This book, Karukku, was written in Tamil and was translated into English by Lakshmi Holmstrom. I will read what this book is about. In this unusual autobiography, a young woman, Bama, looks back on her life from a moment of personal crisis as she leaves the religious order to which she belonged for 7 years. She recreates her childhood in her village through a series of poignant memories and self-reflections. Most importantly, she examines the simple faith with which she grew up as a Roman Catholic and restates it in the light of her experience as a Dalit and a woman. This book, Karukku, by Bama, I hope you will find a copy to read it. They may take away our stories from the syllabus, but how are they going to stop us from reading them, from listening to these stories? So this is for Bama, Karukku.